Yugito Lamay there in Mumbai. Increasingly, people in Asia are turning to mobile finance apps instead of heading to their bank or ATM. Well, the use of finance apps has more than doubled in the region since 2014. And more than, listen to this, 110 billion sessions took place in finance apps in Asia in 2016. So what's driving these trends? For more, I'm joined now by Al Campa from App Annie, which compiles data on the application market. Mr. Campa, thank you so much for joining us. You came all the way from San Francisco to attend a conference here in Asia. So what explains the growth of these finance apps in Asia?
Well, my company tracks millions of apps in over 50 countries around the world. So we have a bird's eye view of the key trends, and these financial apps have really been taking off. These are apps that allow you to deposit checks via taking a picture or move money or pay bills via mobile. And they've been growing, as you cited the numbers, very large here in Asia at over 100 billion sessions last year.
But that, I'm sure, comes from a low base, because a lot of Asians are still quite financial illiterate.
Actually, Asia is the largest market for the use of financial apps, over twice as many users as you see in the Americas or in Europe, and it's growing at over 100% a year. In fact, in China, downloads grew 200% over the last 2 years, and in Southeast Asia, over 150%. And in Australia and South Korea, sessions are approaching 30 per month, which means people are using these apps almost every single day.
Every single day. So we're quite surprised with all of these numbers. But particularly, where are these financial applications being used? I'm sure the likes of Japan, Singapore, South Korea, most of the developed economies here in Asia. What about Southeast Asia?
No, it's definitely in the developed economies. And it makes a lot of sense, because from the financial institution standpoint, if you can get users to do more transactions via the mobile app, to take pictures, to move money, to use it for payment, that means they're going to the branches less, and they're going to ATMs less. So they need fewer branches, fewer ATMs, and overall, they save a lot of money.
But Mr. Campa, these apps vary so dramatically between markets. Can't there just be one standard app Asia-wide?
Well, every bank has its own app. And in fact, many banks have numerous apps that do different things. What we see in Asia is often the numerous apps in Southeast Asia driving different transactions. And in Australia, we see the Uber apps of one app like ANZ and ING doing everything.
And briefly, how do you deal with cyber attacks?
Most banks will secure transactions via your mobile app the same way they do via credit card. So if there's fraud, you simply report it, and the banks will secure the transactions.
All right. So there's a layer of security support there. Thank you so much for joining us, Al Campa from App Annie.
Thank you for having me.
All right. The surprise house thing of the